Eastern Cape Health MEC Sindiswa Gomba is visiting the Glen Grey Hospital. This is in an attempt to resolve issues raised by medical personnel at the hospital after 14 COVID-19 patients were moved there from a guest house. The guest house was earmarked to quarantine those 14 patients. Medical staff at the hospital claim that they've not been provided with sufficient personal protective equipment, while the health department claims that they have. We cross to our reporter, Yanga Funani, to tell us more. Thanks very much, Yanga, for joining us. Just tell us what the latest is, where you are.
Very good afternoon to you, Nompu, and to the scores upon scores of our viewers. Indeed, you are coming to us live from Glen Grey Hospital in Lady Frey, where the Provincial Health Department MEC Mamu Sindiswa Gomba is currently visiting. This follows cries from the workforce here, telling them that this hospital is in no position to host people who have been found positive of COVID-19 because the medical staff here are not protected. But to tell us more about those lamentations, we are now joined by Dinosa Chairperson in this region, and his name is Andisile Pamila. So a very good afternoon to you, and thank you very much for joining us. Tell us, what are some of the complaints you have raised with the Provincial Health Department?
Thank you, leadership. The complaints that we are receiving is that the department, in particular the management of Glen Grey Hospital, has brought the patient who have tested positive in this particular hospital, and the hospital itself is not ready to quarantine this particular patient who have tested positive. The area where currently they are accommodated itself is not suitable to accommodate people who have tested positive. Secondly, you've got the staff that is not trained, is not equipped to deal with this coronavirus. Also, you've got the staff that is not being supplied by what you call the protective clothing, the gear that they are supposed to use in order to deal or to nurse the patient with this coronavirus. So we're saying the management has been reckless in dealing with this particular situation to accommodate these patients here. Currently, you have a situation whereby the MEC is here, and the SG was here on Thursday, telling the nurses that nurses are not going to enter in this ward that is quarantining these people who have tested positive. However, during the weekend, we've received many complaints from the nurses that are being threatened by the management, saying that they are going to charge and they are going to dismiss some of the nurses who refuse to go inside that particular ward to nurse those patients. And we're saying, as an organization, we're very clear as Dinosa to say, the staff, the nurses, must not go near those patients without protective clothing, which are in the guidelines by the World Health Organization. Yes.
Okay. We see that they have been moved. They were accommodated in this room where people who are suffering from TB had to be moved to a medical ward. Tell us about that.
Yes. Thank you. We find ourselves in a situation whereby on Friday, the management quickly moved the patient with TB from here in this medical ward to another ward, which is a surgical ward, and also move the patient who were in the male surgical ward to a ward where there were patients with mental illnesses, psychiatric patients. Now, you find a situation whereby now this ward, it tells you clear that this ward was never prepared to accommodate COVID-19 patient. Now, if you are talking of a ward that is being prepared to accommodate COVID patient who have tested positive with COVID-19, there will be an area where the nurse will get there in order to wear the corrective gear, and there will be an area where the nurse will have to go, where the nurse will need to change and go to shower. There must be showers that are being prepared there so that the nurse, before that nurse go and wear his or her clothes will need to go and shower first so that that particular nurse will disinfect themselves. And also, these nurses, as we said before, that they are not well-trained because this particular virus, it does not only spread because you are not wearing the protective clothing. It also spread even to by those who are wearing these protective clothing because they are not equipped enough so that they are knowledgeable in terms of how do you take those protective clothing off when you are changing from that particular ward. So we're saying as an organization, since this ward is not being prepared to accommodate these patients, these patients are not isolated, and the space between their bed is not enough so that one patient does not infect another. So this situation here was saying the management was reckless in dealing with the situation. The hospital is not ready and the staff is not equipped enough, is not knowledgeable. You can't only talk about telling the nurses and the healthcare workers in terms of what is COVID-19. Anyone can go and read what is COVID-19. You need to go and train and equip nurses so that they are able to deal with this virus. Looking at the statistics of Eastern Cape currently is growing sharply in terms of people who are continuously testing positive as well moving forward, which tells you clearly that Eastern Cape, in dealing with this COVID-19, it was not prepared first to deal with COVID-19. Secondly, in dealing with this, it's managing this COVID-19 virus poorly.
Mr. Pambal, thanks a lot for your time, sir.
Thank you, leadership.
And that's, of course, the chairperson of DINORSA in this particular area telling us that their staff, the nurses, are not protected enough. He's telling us that they've opted to stay away from the wards. If you look behind us where the patients have been quarantined, the windows are wide open. Far left, they are hanging clothes over there of some of the patients. The department will answer soon as they are done with meeting the management of the hospital. From us here in Glengrey Hospital, Vuyo Funani is behind the lens, and Amyanga Funani, it's back to you in studio.
Thanks very much, my colleague there, Yanga Funani.